tonight. South Australia's power shame. Disconnections surge as more and more bills go unpaid. The alleged architect of the Tippett deal breaks his silence as a plea bargain looms. Ricky Ponting calls stumps on his cricketing career. And retiring Wiggles spark spontaneous delight among Adelaide's littlest hot potatoes. Good evening. The Essential Services Watchdog has revealed more and more South Australians can't pay their spiralling power bills. Disconnections and hardship cases are on the rise, along with complaints about retailers.
Skyrocketing electricity costs are taking their toll on South Australian households, some paying a higher price than others.
Disconnection rates tend to be cyclical. They go up and down depending on the economy, but also I think price rises over the last couple of years have also had an impact.
The Essential Services Commission's annual performance report shows disconnections for non-payment up 34% to nearly 10,000. Consumers on hardship plans were up 8.1% and those on payment plans up 6.5%.
We switch off the lights or whatever we do what we can to conserve power, but our bills still keep coming up.
Well, the economic times we're in. No one can afford to pay their bills.
Incredible how much the prices keep going up.
There's a corresponding increase in complaints to retailers.
A lot of that is billing related, whether it's incorrect bills, but also increased prices have also had an impact on that one.
The report shows just how soaring prices are affecting users of electricity that they can neither afford nor afford to go without.
That's prompting concerns that distressed customers might endanger themselves by switching off cooling.
And if they feel that they're driven to take those steps, we'd like them to contact government agencies so that we can give them the support necessary to allow them to turn on their air conditioners.
The report coincides with claims by the Energy Users Association that South Australians are paying dearly for the lack of competition in the wholesale market, pointing to enormous spot price spikes on a handful of days between 2007 and 2011. Alan Murrell, 10.